Hello, race fans, and welcome back to round 14 of the 2022 IDFRS's AI Cup Series. Last time, Apex Colonel finally gets his win at Pocono. And where does Colonel start today? He's going to be in row 7 next to three-time winner, Cam Jordan. As we look at the point standings, well, it's going to be a tough charge from 2nd to 1st place. Without further ado, let's get down to the starting grid and find out where everyone is running today. And here is your starting grid at Seattle. Starting with row 1 on the pole, we have Roll Tide and Colonel Sanders. Row 2 is Josh Bonkowski and Dave Wilson. Row 3 is Sir Tyler and Chris Abel. Row 4 is Wayne and Ghost Rider. Row 5 is Buster and Shemp Howard. Row 6 is KRX and General Kenobi. Row 7 is Apex Colonel and Cam Jordan. Row 8 is Arthur WV and Cam Hornsby. Row 9 is Aaron Abel and Zaya 0085. Row 10 is Marco Andretti and Luna. Row 11 is Beavis and Yuzua. Row 12 is Wilson Hunt and Phantom. Row 13 is Sky Ladosa and Carter Stevens. Row 14 is Alex Porter and Ryan Hunter Wright. Rounding out the last row is Henry McGee and Akuma. Alright, stories for today's race. Apex Colonel looking to move up front. Cam Jordan hopefully getting another win. Roll Tide of Warpath Racing League's up front. Sir Tyler hopefully looking to do better this season. And Wayne hoping to outperform everybody here today. Pace Car is now taking the field through turns 3 and 4. This is a long super speedway, so the warm-up lap took a little longer than expected. Pace Car is now dropped off pit road as the cars exit onto the front straightaway. Who is going to lead the first lap as they cross the line for the green flag? Green flag is out as the cars get ready to cross the line. And it's going to be Roll Tide that takes the lead. Going down into turn one, they go side by side. We have Roll Tide, Josh, and Sir Tyler on the inside with Colonel Sanders all alone in the middle row. Josh moves into third, and Sir Tyler gets third place. Wayne has moved up quickly and is already in the top 5. The cars are starting to fan out on the back straightaway. We see Apex Colonel, and it looks like General Kenobi breaking away from the pack, taking the inside line. Coming down to turn 3, it's going to be Roll Tide and Josh in the middle, with Sir Tyler moving down to the inside. Coming down the front straightaway, they're breaking off into 2 and 3, and I think I see 4 wide in the middle of the pack. Roll Tide is going to lead them down, he's going to get his first point. Wayne moves into 3rd place, and Sir Tyler has moved into 2nd, they're 3 wide coming down through turn 2. Wayne moves into the lead, Apex Colonel gets 2nd place, and Buster's going to follow behind in 3rd, it looks like. Roll Tide is stuck to the outside row. This is not good, as usually the traffic starts to fall back if you stay up on the high banking. Roll Tide kisses the barrier on turn 3. He's going to start falling back. Dropping down to 11th place, it looks like. As we complete our second lap, Wayne is going to get his bonus point. We have Apex Colonel in 2nd, however Buster is going to challenge him for 2nd place as they go through turn 1. Buster takes the inside line, he's going to take Arthur WV, General Kenobi, and Colonel Sanders with him. Nope, that is the 5 car of Aaron Abel. Looks like Colonel touched the barrier on the back straightaway. And we see some battling going on from 20th to 30th place. As the top 9 start to break away from the field, double file coming into turn 4. Arthur WV moves into 2nd place, and he's taking the 52 of Marco Andretti with him. Arthur gets 2nd place from Buster, and Marco Andretti is going to follow him on the inside line through turn 2. KRX has now moved up into the top 10. He's catching the draft off the 5 car, and here comes the 24 Roll Tide, who's caught up. Once again, side-by-side action on the back straightaway. It's going to be a tandem draft between the 31 and the 52. Beavis and Sir Tyler both kiss the side barrier of turn 3 and 4. They get loose, and they're going to fall back. Cars once again fanning out on the front stretch. New leader starting this lap is going to be Marco Andretti. He does really well at the road courses. We don't see him very often here on the oval tracks. He usually finishes mid-pack, sometimes towards the tail end of the field. However, any bonus points he can get for leading a lap will add to his total throughout the season. Aaron Abel now moves into second place, challenging the lead from Marco Andretti. KRX, Roll Tide, and Wilson Hunt are going to come behind Aaron Abel as they once again fan out and complete another lap. 3OI once again going into turn 1. Roll Tide on the inside, KRX in the middle, and Aaron Abel on the outside. Roll Tide is getting drafted off at the 86, the 95, the 6, and the 2 car. Alex Porter is also using the inside line to catch up to the pack. There's still 3x3 going into turn 3 as we go on board with Apex Colonel, who is in the middle. We see some slower traffic coming back on the pit road. That's going to be the 1 car of Josh Bonkowski. Looks like he had to make an emergency pit stop, as we're not sure of who the slower car is up ahead of the field. See Marco Andretti on the outside trying to pass Colonel, and here comes the 95 Buster on the inside. Roll Tide trying to hold on to that lead position in the middle row. It's not working out for him, as both Wayne and KRX are about to pass him, coming down towards the front stretch. Colonel's going to the outside now. Use the draft of the 16 car to catch up. And contact on the back straightaway. It's going to be the 16, the 5, and the 2 car. Luna starts pushing Aaron Abel off and right onto the back straight. Looking at the replay from what happened, KRX went down and bumped into the 5 car, which caused a chain reaction. Colonel Sanders got involved as well. And of course, Luna being aggressive, she pushes Aaron Abel back onto the track. Caution is out for this lap, and thankfully it's not too long of a caution. Josh Bonkowski is looking to be the lucky dog and hoping to get his lap back as the caution lap comes to its end. Your leader is Wayne, followed by Ryan Hunter Ray, Ghost Rider, Phantom, ZA-85, Roll Tide, Sir Tyler, Wilson Hunt, Akuma, and it looks like Alex Porter. And the green flag is out. Josh doesn't get the acceleration, however, he does have the inside line, which is going to allow him to stay even with the 0 car in hopes of getting a lap back and keeping it that way. Josh and Wayne are side by side coming down the back straightaway. Ghost Rider breaks off from the pack and he's going to try to make his own group. Josh is now getting a draft off the 34, and Phantom moves out of the way. He's going to dig deep on the inside line. He's going to take Zeta and Roll Tide with him. Now they're 3 wide from 1st to 6th place. Alex Porter sticks to the middle, and I think Sir Tyler is going to do the same as well. Slingshotting off of turn 4, Phantom is going to get the lead. Zeta is going to move into 2nd place. Josh is starting to fall farther back, as Lee is once again contested between the 3 drivers as they exit turn 2. Almost some contact there with Wilson Hunt in the mid-pack. Thankfully, no accident yet. Down turn three, there's still three wide. Phantom on the inside, Zeta in the middle, and Roll Tide on the inside row. However, the inside line has more cars, and they're going to push ahead. We just saw Josh hit the tire barrier again on turn four, and he's going to start falling back towards the tail end of the field, therefore not getting his lap back. Side-by-side action between the 24 and the 85 going into turn one. Roll Tide is going to reclaim the lead. Ghost Rider, Zeta, and Sir Tyler battle it out for second place going through turn two. And the winner of that one's going to be Sir Tyler. Exiting turn two, he's going to move to the inside line. He's going to challenge Ghost Rider for second place. Cars fanning out on the back straightaway, trying to break off and form their own groups as they go through turn three. Still side by side for half of the pack. Sir Tyler moves into the lead, and Akuma's going to draft off of him for second place. Skyladosa has now moved into the top three, and he currently has nobody drafting him. That's going to put him back into sixth place. Akuma's on the inside, going through turn one. We have Sir Tyler in the middle, and we have Skyladosa and Roll Tide right behind. Ghost Rider gets pushed back, almost hits the barrier, exiting turn two. At this point, it's a matter of who can get the inside line, gain a point, and then shuffle back. Alex Porter is hoping to finish ahead of Wayne, as we see the zero car has now moved back and is currently in the top 15 from what it looks like. Phantom hits the barrier again. He's just dragging himself, starting to fall back. Looks like 12th place, and Bonkowski has come off of pit road once again. Seems like he's having all kinds of problems here tonight. Oh, contact between the 18. No, it was the 0 and the 1 car, but no caution, as there wasn't any slowdown on the back straightaway. We have a second place battle between the 95, the 38 of Henry McGee, 95. Oh, it looks like it's going to be 38, 95, and 24 battling out for third place as Akuma's moved ahead of the pack and has some clean air. Skylados is going to draft right behind him in second place and hopefully push him ahead, so this way those two can get as many points as they can, as we are almost halfway done at Seattle. Akuma has not had a great start this year, involved in multiple accidents, and currently in the top, at least, mid-20s in the standings, as we watch a good portion of the field coming in for their first mandatory pit stop of the race. Hopefully Akuma will have a quick splash and go and get back out into a get ahead of the field. And we're going to see who will take first place coming off of pit road. Contact between the 6 and the 24. I don't know what happened there, but Colonel Sanders seems awfully upset. And he's going to beat the pack off of pit road. Close battle there between the 95 and I think it was the 96 car. As we watch everyone else come off and finish their pit stops. Akuma's caught up to the sixth car of Colonel Sanders and is going to contest that position from him. We are down to 13 laps here at Seattle, and the position is going to go to the 96 car of Akuma. Chris Abel's coming off pit road and hoping to rejoin the pack. As we see Sir Tyler and Henry McGee rejoining the field, this is going to shrink the gap from first to third. Akuma takes the outside line, and he's going to slingshot past the 38 cars that come down the front straightaway. Your current running order as of this lap is going to be Sir Tyler up front, Akuma in second, Dave Wilson in third, followed by Cam Jordan, Henry McGee, Apex Colonel, and Buster, along with Colonel Sanders. Sir Tyler's also another story. We haven't seen him up front for a long time. His best finish has been second place, and that was at Daytona. Apex Colonel takes fourth place away from Dave Wilson, and Cam Jordan is currently in third. Cam Jordan is looking to get another win here at Seattle. One of our younger rookies currently has the most wins this season, but has not been finishing very high up in the standings, which is kind of a double-edged sword for him. He's done really strong in the beginning of the season and has started to taper off, so he's going to need a good finishing position if he wants to move up in the championship. Close battle here between the 9 and the 96 going into turn 3. However, Apex Colonel sticks his nose in and goes down the middle between the two. And it's going to be a battle for third as we go down turn 4. Dave Wilson, our winner at Talladega, is now challenging last week's winner for third place. Colonel's trying to hold his own on the middle row as they go into turn 1. And Wilson's going to get a draft off of Buster in the 95. This is going to push him to keep up with Apex Colonel, who is getting drafted by two other cars. And it looks like the 95 is going hard on the pedal, trying to push the 20 car up front. Wilson is now challenging Cam Jordan for fourth place. It's almost like we're having a tandem draft as these four behind Apex Colonel are swapping positions. And currently, they're pulling far ahead of Sanders, Skyladosa, and Alex Porter. 10 laps to go at Seattle. Apex Colonel is now on the offensive and is slingshotting past the 0-0 car. They're side-by-side down the back straightaway. However, Akuma, Dave Wilson, Cam Jordan... Nope, both Akuma and Dave Wilson go down. They decided last minute to swap positions and their driving line. Apex Colonel is all by his lonesome exiting turn 4, and he's going to take the lead from Sir Tyler. Great passing for positions from 1st to 7th place. Colonel almost cuts off Akuma, but decides he's going to stick to the middle row once again. And they're going to be side-by-side coming down through turn 2. Buster moves in the middle and cuts right in front of the 20 car. Buster is now currently in 5th place, which may be 4th. Buster is also another contender. He had an engine trouble at the start of Pocono, and that dropped him to last place in the point standings. So Buster is looking to accumulate points and not finish last this season. Akuma is now our leader with Cam Jordan in second place. And it looks like the position for the lead is going to be changing once again as Cam Jordan, Buster, and Henry McGee take the inside line. Second round of pit stops as Cam Jordan and Dave Wilson come down. Carrick's the slower car is going to hold up the 96 car, giving the 15 car some air to breathe. And thanks to Carrick's, Apex Colonel has been able to get the lead back. And right behind is the 95 of Buster and Harry McGee, as Akuma and Sir Tyler are starting to fall back due to the 16 car. Apex Colonel and Buster now come into pit. Furthest down the road is the 6-car of Apex Kernel. And how many tires is he going to go for? And Apex Kernel beats them all off pit road. Second place is going to be Buster. Third is going to go to Sanders, then Akuma, Wilson Hunt, Alex Porter, Sky Lodosa. And it's going to be a drag race between Ryan Hunter and Phantom, along with Carter Stevens in the 61 car. Next up is Shemp Howard, Cam Hornsby, it was, in the 46. So Tyler and Henry McGee have just come back on the pit road, and this is going to allow Cam Jordan to slingshot by for second, and now the lead. Apex Kernel is going to follow him on the outside line, and they're going to move up into the front. So Tyler comes back on and merges with traffic. Henry McGee is going to follow right behind him. Once again, slower traffic up ahead, which will be the determining factor if these two can keep their distance from third and fourth. As we are now down to the last five laps. Apex Kernel takes the lead on the inside of turn two, passing Cam Jordan. Bonkowski is currently two laps down. See Cam Jordan going high on turn three, almost touched the barrier, but thankfully didn't, as that would have been the end of his race. Bonkowski stays in the middle line, and Apex Kernel is going to squeeze by. Cam Jordan is going to follow him, and tries to move to the inside. Decides not to, as he doesn't have the draft to slingshot by Kernel. Coming down through turn three, Apex Kernel goes high on the banking, and Cam Jordan dips down. They're side by side exiting turn four. It's only a matter of time to find out who's going to get the lead. Sir Tyler decides he's going to draft off of Cam Jordan as he makes the pass on Josh Bonkowski. Three laps to go. Poor Eddie McGee is currently in fourth place, and he has nobody to draft off of at the moment. And Sir Tyler starts to push Cam Jordan ahead. It's only enough to keep Apex Kernel away. Cam Jordan has only two laps to go to hold on to the lead. Apex Kernel almost touched the barrier again. Going into turn one, he's now dropped to fourth place. Sir Tyler in second, Harry McGee in third place, and Josh Bonkowski is finally out of the way. Something's up with Apex Kernel's car. I think his arrow is a little damaged after he touched the barrier. He's starting to struggle to keep up with the pack. Cars are now single file. White flag this time, one lap to go. Will Cam Jordan get his fourth win this season? Henry McGee's holding on to second place as Sir Tyler is on the outside. Apex Kernel looks like he's gonna draft right behind the 38 car as the one car, being an Alex Porter, is starting to be a pest. Down through turn three and down through turn four they come. Sir Tyler is going to try and make the pass on the 38 car for second place. And our winner, his fourth win this season, crossing the star finish line, is going to be Cam Jordan. Second is going to go to Henry McGee. Third is Sir Tyler. And fourth is Apex Colonel. We'll be right back after this commercial break for the results and point standings.
Anybody got any requests?
Yeah. Please stop.
Congratulations on your fourth win, Cam Jordan. Now let's take a look at the results. Second place went to Henry McGee. Third was Sir Tyler. Fourth, Apex Colonel. Fifth, Akuma, his best finish so far, in the top five. Then we have Skylodosa, Alex Porter, Buster, Wilson Hunt, and Dave Wilson rounding out the top 10. Followed by Chris Abel, Zeta, Carter Stevens, Phantom, Ghost Rider, Wayne, Ryan Hunter Ray, Cam Hornsby, Sham Power, General Kenobi, Luna, Arthur WV, Beavis, Aaron Abel, Roll Tide, Colonel Sanders, KRX, Marco Andretti, Josh Bonkowski, and Yuzua. Oh, that's right, Yuzua unfortunately had taken some engine damage and had to retire from the race. As for the point standings, Alex Porter still leads with 548, and Wayne is only 20 points behind. Apex Colonel has now moved into the top three. Dave Wilson is in 4th, Zeta 5th, Luna 6th, Ryan Hunter Ray 7th, Yuzua and Wilson Hunt tied respectively for 8th place, Henry McGee in 9th, and Sir Tyler in the top 10. However, 1 point behind is Chris Abel, then we have Phantom, Cam Hornsby, Roll Tide, who is 1 point ahead of Ghost Rider, Carter Stevens, Colonel Sanders, who is 2 points ahead of Cam Jordan, Arthur WV, Josh Bonkowski, KRX, Beavis, Skylodosa, who is 3 points ahead of Aaron Abel. Then we have General Kenobi, Akuma, Buster, Shemp Howard, and Marco Andretti with 299 points. All right, folks, thank you for tuning in, and our next race on the season will be the Indianapolis Raceway Park. Take care, and see you then.